a pen. I need a pen. How to upgrade the RAM of your iMac cheap the right way? I mean, memory upgrade on the 27-inch iMac is very easy. You just need a pen. But if you want the best possible performance, spending less money, there are some things we need to discover, like, can I use different RAM sticks together? Is it okay to mix RAM brands or to mix different RAM sizes? Is there a correct slot order for the best performance? Do I really need 16 or 32 gigabytes? How much RAM is enough? Will more memory really make Final Cut faster? I found the results very interesting, and I will show you now on Geek Detour. Let's do it again. One of the main reasons I use a Mac instead of a PC is Final Cut Pro X. It renders videos faster than anything else. By the way, if you are buying an iMac and you are choosing between the 21-inch or the 27-inch model, trust me, get the big one. Not only for the bigger screen, but mostly for the ability to change the RAM yourself, for a much cheaper price than Apple's RAM, easily using this door at the back. The 21-inch iMacs requires you to literally unglue the display and disassemble almost the whole computer to access the RAM. You won't. Get the big one with the best CPU you can pay. When I bought mine, I paid an extra for the quad-core i7, but the RAM was unchanged, 8 GB, and during these 5 years, 8 gigs were enough for me. Every video you saw on my channel so far was edited on Final Cut Pro with only 8 gigs of RAM, but my projects are getting more complex with bigger files, and some of the footage is now shot in 2.7K or even 4K, so I wonder if more memory will make Final Cut faster or better somehow. I won't spoil the surprise. Before you buy anything, you need to know which type of memory your Mac needs. So, you click on the Apple menu and choose the About This Mac. And there you have the model of your Mac. Write down this information, then go to the Memory tab. My iMac came with 2 sticks of 4 gigs and 2 additional free slots, and on the memory upgrade instructions. If you have a newer Mac, it might support 64 gigabytes or even more, but as you can see, my iMac only goes up to 32 gigabytes of RAM. I unplugged everything, and to protect the display from scratches, I used a towel. And there is the memory door. To open it, you remove the power cable and there is a hidden button that you can press with a pen and the door opens. You push the levers apart, outwards, lift, and now you can add memory sticks. It is so easy that, with a bit of practice, you can do it even without laying down the iMac. Now you just put memory, close the door and boom, everything faster. Not really. And here is where I saw some confusion on forums and on YouTube. Indeed, if you mix memory sticks of different sizes and put them in any order, good chances that your Mac will just work fine. I tested a few weird combinations and the Apple hardware test on boot always gave me good. And that is very disappointing. The Mac should warn you, because it's not all the same. Depending on the order, you get different results. So, for the question, can I mix different memory sizes? Yes, you can. But there is a correct arrangement to make the memory operate in dual-channel mode. Of course, the easiest way to avoid compatibility problems and get the best performance is to buy 4 identical memory sticks, exactly the same brand, type and capacity. Fill the 4 slots and you are fine, but it's more expensive. Instead, here is what I did. I kept my original 8 GB in 2 sticks of 4, and I only bought additional 16 GB, 2 sticks of 8. And the correct order for the best performance was from bottom to top. 8 gigs, 4 gigs, 8 gigs, 4 gigs. This is how it looks like on the system information, and this configuration runs on dual channel. By the way, I couldn't find any way on the macOS itself to see if the memory is operating on dual channel or not. I saw it by running a benchmark and measuring the RAM transfer speed. If you know any other way, please tell me in the comments. There is a huge debate if dual channel is really so much better than single channel, especially on games. The thing is, even if the difference is not that great on all applications, why would you run your computer in single channel mode? Just buy the correct memory sticks in pairs, put them in the correct order and get the best possible performance. About Final Cut Pro, I did some testings with 8GB and after upgrading to 24GB, rendering the same project, and I noticed something really strange. Now that Final Cut has much more memory to use, I thought it would use all that memory, right? But when I looked in the activity monitor, I saw that Final Cut itself was using the same amount of RAM. So, is it not using all the available RAM? Yes, it is, but in the form of cached files. All the footage that you are editing is stored as files on your hard disk or SSD. And when you have more available RAM, OS X will load and keep those files in memory. In terms of rendering time, more RAM doesn't make Final Cut export your project much faster. The difference is minimum. But here is the deal. To me, Final Cut already exports fast enough. And I do it only once, when I finish editing. The big difference I noticed after putting more RAM was on the responsiveness when scrubbing through the project, adjusting the clips. I mean, with more RAM, the experience of editing gets better. And if you are doing YouTube videos, you probably don't need 32GB. I felt that 16GB or 24GB is enough for me. So if you are in doubt between maxing the RAM capacity of your iMac or moving to an SSD storage, the SSD might be the best use of your money. And that will be my next step with my iMac. I want to buy a 2TB external SSD. Do you also use an old Mac? Did you make any upgrade? Share a story in the comments. I read everything. Subscribe, turn on that bell, and thanks for watching.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, how many times should I do it? Do you have it?